Equity investors were caught on the wrong side of the markets last week as valuation concerns, coupled with persistent selling by FIIs, kept upside in check on the bourses. The BSE Sensex and the Nifty 50 slipped about 1% each during the week to end at 60,822 and 18,115 respectively last Friday. While analysts remain cautious for the week ahead as well, they say the markets are likely to stabilize with sectoral rotation taking place.
What we have seen this week was a mixture of profit booking and since we are already into the result season, so and markets have also ran up ahead of the result. So some kind of a rotation also we are seeing based on the outcome in the results. And next week, definitely, as far as broader markets are concerned, it looks like it should settle somewhere. And we might not see much amount of selling as we have seen this week. So next week we could see some kind of area where the market finds its place, and then from there onwards we might see some sectoral rotation coming up.
For Nischal Maheshwari, who is CEO Institutional Equities at Centrum Broking, last week's correction had valuation and tapering concerns at play.
It's more to do basically with that. In November, basically, you will have Fed coming in and announcing the tapering. And I think the world over, they are preparing for that, basically. If you look at it, the FI selling is what is creating the pressure. It's not anything else. Yesterday also, the number was 2,000 crore plus selling of FIs. So, that's where the pressure is coming from.
Going ahead, volatility may remain high due to corporate earnings and primary market action. The key driver for today's session will be Q2 results of Reliance Industries and ICICI Bank, which were released post-market hours on Friday and Saturday respectively. During the rest of the week, investors' reaction to September quarter earnings of L&T, Maruti Suzuki, ITC, Axis Bank, Cipla, Adani Ports and Titan will sway the indices. That apart, the initial public offering of India's biggest cosmetics e-tailer, Nykaa, may also catch investor fancy this week. FSN E-commerce Ventures, the parent company of Nykaa, will launch its IPO on Thursday, October 28, to raise over 5,355 crore rupees at a price band of 1,085 and 1,125 rupees per share. Separately, Fino Payments Bank is also expected to launch its 1,300 crore rupee IPO on Friday, October 29. But will these primary share sales affect secondary market inflows?
Yes, a lot of primary market money which was maybe likely to flow into the secondary market is being now targeted to the primary market. So you may see a little lesser action.
That said, analysts believe issue pricing and investor appetite will play an important role in trading activity.
That is dependent upon the valuations at which the various issues comes back. So it would be very issue specific. So I don't think broadly we should be anticipating any less enthusiasm over the ICO. The ICO primary markets are still very good in terms of enthusiasm. So we should continue to see a good response by the public, provided the valuations are such that there is something left on the table for the investors.
As per tech charts, the 50 share index is likely to trade within a range of 17,750 and 18,375, while the Sensex may trade within a broad range of 59,700 and 61,900.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.